Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about web scraping. Web scraping is a technique to extract the content from a website. For example, if you have a website like Amazon.com and you want to write a piece of the code which can go to the Amazon website and find out the price of that item and give it to you. And you can use it for any other purpose, for data processing or something. So this is just a one liner or two liner about the web scraping. We are going to develop a tool which can go to the NSE India website and it can give you the price of a particular stock. So we are going to use a variable and you enter that what is the stock code or a symbol and it will give you the price of that stock. So it will go to the NSE website and using web scraping it will return you the price of that stock. Okay, for this purpose we are going to use two libraries. One is, okay, before that let me tell you that we are going to develop this code in the Python and we are going to use two libraries for the Python, which is a request and beautiful soup. So the request library is to send HTML request to download the content, website content locally, and the beautiful soup library is to extract or filter or find out a particular value from the downloaded content. So how we will achieve this one? Let me show you that one. So let me first, this is NSE India website. So for example, you can see that there's an Asian Paint Limited stock we are using and the price is 1373.95, which is visible here. If just do a right click here and click on inspect, it will open the inspection window. Click on the element inspection, click on the price, and you can see that one in this whole inspection content it is showing a span ID. Okay, it's a tag, a span ID which is having a value or name last price, and the value is 1373.95, which is actually the stock price. So our ultimate goal is to download the content from the request library, then use beautiful soup to find out what is the value of this last price span ID tag. So let us see that how we are going to achieve it. I will be using a Jupyter Note. It is a very good Python editor, online editor, where you can run your code line by line, and if there's any error, you can fix it, and you can see the output step by step. I have already running Jupyter Note. Before we go to the actual writing the code, I request that one subscribe the channel, and if you think that this video is worthy and you learned something, please like it. So click new Python 3. I open this editor. So from here we will start writing the code. Just one thing, if you write a code, you can click on the run button to execute the code and you will see the output, or you press shift enter key, this will execute the code. So first let me import the two libraries. Import request from BS4, import beautiful. Keep in mind that one, this is a beautiful soup library which we will use for the web scraping to find out the particular value from the content which we will download. This beautiful soup, B, and all this alphabet are very case sensitive. Type it properly. Press shift enter key to execute that. If you go to the next line, this means everything is okay. Now, I'm going to define here two variables. One is stock symbol. I will just type here Asian Paint, because here we'll be keep changing the value and we will see that different stock value to verify the code. And then stock underscore URL. and this URL will be this NEC India URL. Copy paste here. Okay, we are not going to use this URL as it is because it has a hard-coded value of the Asian paint. So we have to append the value, the variable stock symbol. Symbol. Press enter key, no error. Okay, I would like to print this value also. Print stock URL to ensure everything is fine. It is printing the value. Let me use a different variable here, SBIN. Why I'm doing this one? Now here you can see that it's appended SBIN. If I click this one and if it is redirecting to the right website, this means everything is okay right now. Okay, so it is going to the State Bank of India, which is the code SBIN I put there, and the stock price 357.25 is coming. Let me close this window. Everything is fine here. Now we will start actual piece of the code, writing the actual piece of the code from here. So we are going to send a request to this website to download the content. Let's define a variable response. Request dot get stock. URL, and I'm going to print response. See what is the output. Some error. GGET single G. The response is 200. So the response 200 means that one, the response from the website is okay. This means everything is fine. We got the response, or we can say that one, the content is right now available in the object response. Okay. And how we can see the content? The content we can see by printing print response dot text. Okay, so let me see that one. Yes, see the content is available here. This is a website content. Now, let me tell you one thing. First, I will copy this content and I will go to the editor, some editor. I will just do a copy paste. Copy. I will open VS Code file and I copy the whole content here. And if I go back to the website NEC India, the last price was the span ID tag name, which was having the value of the stock price of the stock. So let me search this here. Where is the stock price? Sorry, last price. Last price. We got three values of the last price. Where is that one? This one, and here is this one. What is this? Yes. So you can see that one. This is returning the value of the stock price, which is 357.25. And since I have given the stock code State Bank of India, let me give here SBIN, State Bank of India. .25 is the right value. Okay, now the next part is, our ultimate goal is to find this last price. And if you see that when this whole content has this division ID, and this division ID is having the block of the content, which is basically having this last price. So if somehow we remove the extra content and just having this division ID, which has the ID response div, this I will copy paste because actually we are going to use it. So if we filter out, or if we extract only this piece of the code which is inside this response div division ID, then we have a more refined the code. And how we are going to do it? Here, the beautiful soup is going to help us. So let me go back to the code again. Okay. I will just response, remove it too. So I will define a variable soup, soup is equal to, and Beautiful soup. I will just give you a response dot txt. HTML dot parser. So here, the content which I was showing you before that, which we got from the response dot txt text content, we are going to pass it to a beautiful soup library, and it is going to use the parser, which is HTML parser, so that it can parse the whole content and it can understand the structure of the whole HTML content. Okay, so I did it, and then what I'm going to do that one, print soup, soup. Let us see what is the output. Something wrong. B-E-A. Very cautious of the spelling. So you can see that whole content is here. It is a bit more refined content compared to the previous one. But leave it, don't go and look into too much. Our next point is basically, from this content, we need to extract the division part, which is having response.div ID. So again, I'm going to store that content in another variable, which is the data array. So you can put any variable name, data array. Soup object, find out the division ID, this one. Okay, press enter. No, just print this one also, print data underscore array, and see what is output. You can see that one, it is only printing the division which is having the division ID responsive, which I was showing you here in the this piece of the this here in this editor. So the extra part is gone, and we have a very precise content, and we have if you can see that we have a last price here. Okay, so we have now very limited content, so we are just basically refining the content to reach our goal. Actually, you can see that it has some white spaces. We can remove that white spaces by strip strip method, right? Okay, I mean, it is just, we need to use get text. Get text method. And so if you see that one, right now it is not showing the division ID tag. It is only showing the text actually. Okay, and here we can use split stripe. Oh my God, I'm doing this mistake. So you can see that white spaces are gone actually. And we have very refined content, which is having the last price. Again, I can show here the last price here. And see, we have this content. Now I'm going to convert this content to the delimited content. And if you see that one, this everything is basically having a double colon. Okay, so we can easily use this double colon as a delimiter to separate out the content. So I'm going to use split method. And I will use this one to create a list. Okay, so now it is in a list format. And what we have to do that one? We have a list. This list contains a lot of things. Plus, this list also contains last price also. Okay, and next to the last price is our stock price. So somehow we have to find out this stock price. This is our ultimate goal, to find out this one. How we can get it? See, we cannot go and find out this value, because we cannot hard code this value, because if you are going to get the live data, this will be keep changing. So we cannot hard code it. But what we can hard code is basically is last price. So if we hard code last price and we find the where is the last price in this list, this is a live list actually, and we find the index of the last price, and then we move the index by one, then that next index will be value. Okay, so you hope you understood this point actually, that we are going to iterate this whole list, and we are going to find out on which index this last price is. So for example, we got that last index is a 10, last price is index is 10, then the value will be at 11th position. So let us do it actually. I'm just going to iterate this value for just writing in a for loop for item in dot underscore array. Okay, if last price in item. Find out the index. So index is equal to data underscore array dot index of item. Okay, and I said that when I will add plus one here to get the index of the value. Okay, let us print this index. It is showing index 72. So at index 72, we have the value. Index 71 is the last price. Okay, so we got the index actually. Now what I'm going to do that one, I'm going to print at this index. Print, let us find. So actually the value is basically, I will use another value, latest. I will say latest price is equal to data array. I mean, this is the array which has everything. So now I'm going to find out what is at index. Okay. And print it. Okay. So you can see that when at this index, it is 357. If suppose I don't give this one, what will come? See, it is not showing the value because it is showing that value till here, which is basically 71th index value. So I delimited using comma. So actually this is 71th, then colon and the value. So value is at 72. This is the reason I added here plus one. Hope this is clear because that is one of the key point. Now when we got this one, our next step is to extract this price. Okay, to extract this price, actually what I'm going to do that one, I'm going to split using delimiter double colon, because if you use this double colon as a delimiter, then this will be one value, then this will be another value, this will be another value, kind of things. I will show you that one. So split okay, now see, now it is coming as a two values actually. Okay, so actually when we split it, it created a, now latest price is also like a array, or you can say it is a list, and it has following value. Now if you want to show that what is the value, this is array value, and if you want to show that what is the value at latest price position 0, it is showing blank, because there is a blank it was showing that one. Let me show you that one again. We'll copy paste this value. So in the first line print, I'm showing all value of the latest price list. Actually, it's showing one blank, then this value, then another content is this one. Now if I press zero, if I give a zero, then it will, zero element is this one blank. This reason it is not showing. But actually if I give one, it will show this price. Bracket, and you can see that it's showing the price. More clarity, I will just remove, or I will hash comment it here so that it will be more clear to you. You can see that when this 357.25 is a price of the State Bank of India stock. So this is our objective, that and we achieve that when we have given this code here and we got the price. So if I give Asian PAINT and I keep executing here the piece of the code, it is showing right now 1373.95. Let us go back to the Asian website. See that one, if Asian Paint 1373.95. You can see that one. So we achieve actually that what we wanted. So you understood that one, how using web scraping we finally able to fetch the stock price using a stock symbol. This is a one session of the video. In the next session we will just work a little bit more this on this code actually to make this more useful, and how we can use to actually buy or sell, or especially to monitor our stock price. Thank you very much. As I said that, please like this video if you learned something and subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.